Hey guys, I'm Dr. Jason Barker with the Natural Athletes Clinic, and today I want to explain to you the differences between type 1 muscle fibers and type 2 muscle fibers. And also stick around because I want to tell you about my top 3 nutritional supplements that I love to use in clinic to help people enhance their muscle recovery, okay? So what are the differences between the two types of muscle fibers? Well, your type 1 are your slow twitch muscle fibers, kind of a slower contraction, weaker contraction. These are smaller muscle fibers. They're very dependent on oxygen, so you'll see a rich capillary blood supply in and around those muscle fibers. They're full of myoglobin, which is a protein that also stores oxygen nearby because they need a lot of energy because they're meant to go for a very, very long time. So of course, these are the muscle fibers that an endurance athlete is going to need. And outside of sports, these are also the muscle fibers that make up a lot of your postural muscles. So holding you up all day, holding your head up all day, those muscles are contracting constantly, but they don't seem to get tired, right? So those are more the type 1. Now, type 2 fibers are larger, they're more powerful, they're meant for short, quick type of contractions, very powerful bursts of energy. They're very short-lived, you know, under 10 seconds at most. They tire out very quickly. They're kind of inefficient, sometimes people will say. They're not dependent on oxygen, they're more dependent on ATP. So they don't have as powerful or as rich of a blood supply as the type 1 fibers do. Now, in the real world, if I could give you a good example of this, we'd be looking at your Thanksgiving turkey. So you know there's the white meat and the dark meat. Well, the dark meat are the type 1 fibers, very rich in blood, very rich in myoglobin. It gives it that brown or that dark appearance. And then your type 2 fibers are the white ones that don't have that rich oxygen supply, so you don't see that coloring in there, and so that tissue is more white. Now, again, in the real world, if you look at a marathoner versus a sprinter, right, two very different body types. Marathoners are lean, not a whole lot of muscle mass because they have a preponderance of those type 1 fibers that are a lot smaller than the type 2 fibers, which are a lot bigger. So if you've ever seen one of these sprinters walking down the street, you wouldn't think they're a runner. You'd think they're a linebacker, right, because they're huge. They've got massive muscles on them, which are mainly those type 2 fibers, which are, of course, meant for very quick, very short, very powerful movements. Now, what are we made out of? So the average sedentary person is about 50-50 type 1 to type 2 fibers. Now, genetics plays a role, training plays a role, but if you are a genetically gifted endurance athlete and you train a lot, you're going to have about 75% of all of your muscle fibers being the type 1 type of fiber. And if you are a power athlete and you train a lot, again, about 75% of your total muscle fibers are going to be the type 2. So those are the kind of the main differences between the two of those. Now, what happens as you age? We start to lose muscle mass, right? Now, unfortunately, you start to lose more of the type 2 fibers as we age, and you actually gain more of those type 1 fibers. Now, I think this is interesting because when we look at power athletes, when we look at sprinters, the younger ones are the ones who typically start breaking the records at an earlier age, meaning, you know, 25, around there. Whereas with the endurance athletes, you tend to see older athletes setting the records. And a good example of this is Craig Alexander, who set a new world Ironman championship record in 2011, and he was age 38 at the time. And by the way, he ran a 6-minute and 16-second mile split in that marathon on that race. So that's pretty impressive for a 38-year-old, whereas you don't see the, you know, 30-somethings breaking sprinting records normally. So maybe that has something to do with how the muscle fibers change as we age. Okay, so how do you help your muscles recover? So the 3 things that I love to use are branched chain amino acids. So you've probably heard of these. These are a special set of amino acids that have very powerful muscle recovery properties to them. So we know that taking branched chain amino acids over plain amino acids can stimulate that muscle recovery process a lot better, a lot more efficiently. And then interestingly, you can also use omega-3 fatty acids to help stimulate muscle recovery. That's one you don't hear a lot about, but there's actually good studies that show that those omega-3s also stimulate that muscle repair and recovery process. Now, interestingly too, is that when you combine the omega-3s and the branched chain amino acids, you get a synergistic effect. So those two supplements are really excellent to use together to help recover those muscle fibers. And then the third one we like to use, we still love to use creatine. It's probably the most studied nutritional supplement out there. How does that work? It helps by replacing those phosphate bonds from broken ATP. Okay, so ATP is your cellular energy. You break off a phosphate and that creates a little spark of energy. Those little phosphate bonds need to get reattached to that ATP. That's what creatine does. It helps replace those a lot quicker, so those muscles can fire more rapidly. They repair themselves a lot quicker too when they've got a rich supply of that creatine. So the cool thing about all of these, creatine takes a little bit to kick in, but the omega-3s and the branched chain amino acids, those will kick in like that. So it's a good test to do. So you go do your run or your workout or whatever, and then you try and use those two supplements together, you're going to recover about twice as fast as you would have had you not used them. And so that's why I love using them in clinic, because people can go home and take them after workout and they're back on the next day. So it's very impressive how quickly it works. So hopefully all this helps you guys out with your knowledge of type 1 and type 2 muscle fibers and how you can get your muscles to recover quickly. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like. Of course, please share this with any other athletes you know. And of course, we're always looking for more subscribers, so please hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching.